You mentioned environmental value. Where's the value there?
Well, once you have your sourcing value in place and you notice that you're actually reducing your footprints because you have this access to used materials and used products, you can think of communicating that to your stakeholders. If you don't communicate that to your stakeholders, there is no business value. You might be helping the planet, you know, you create environmental benefits maybe, but if you don't communicate that to your stakeholders, it's not business value. So you need to do that. People have to realize that, businesses have to realize that. So if you communicate that to your customers, for instance, they might be more loyal to your products and to your company. That's environmental value then. You could also communicate it to municipalities or to governmental institutions, so it's easier for you to deal with legislation.
Customer value, let's focus in on those for a second. Where do customers get value out of this?
Well, once you're setting up a reverse a supply chain to get products back, you can also offer certain services to your customers. You know, you can make it easy for them to return products, or you can make it easy for them to turn in their products for a new product. Or you can, again, offer a new range of products, for instance, refurbished products or environmental friendly products. It all adds to customer satisfaction. And in the long run, of course, you hope that will create more loyalty from your customers. So that's customer value.